Confused about the cosmos? Can't tell a planet from a star? Then give us just 5 minutes, and we'll show you what they are. Jack Horkheimer, Stargazer, director of the Miami Space Transit Planetarium, tells you all about the night sky and the biggest show of all, the universe. And now this week's episode.
Don't miss next week's Night of St. Lawrence's Tears, Perseid Meteor Shower. Greetings, greetings, fellow stargazers. Over 1,700 years ago, on August 10th, 258 AD, a young Roman Christian named Lawrence was martyred by the Emperor Valerian by being roasted alive on a gridiron. Later that night, as his mourners carried his body away, dozens of streaks of light fell from the sky, which prompted his friends to believe that even the heavens were weeping for him. And every year since, almost to the date, the skies weep again on what some still call the Night of St. Lawrence's Tears, which is next Tuesday, August 12th. Today, of course, we know that these tears are really meteors from the annual Perseid meteor shower. And this year it should be pretty good because the moon will set around 1:30 a.m. So there will be no bright moonlight to wipe out the faintest meteors during the best viewing time, which will be between 1:30 a.m. and dawn on Tuesday the 12th. To see them, get as far away from city lights as possible and have clear and very dark skies. Then simply lay back on a lawn chair or sleeping bag facing northeast. To see the most meteors, you should stay up until dawn. No binoculars or telescopes are necessary. Simply slowly scan the skies back and forth and up and down, and you should see a couple dozen Perseid meteors or tears of St. Lawrence per hour. Now, although meteors are often called and look like shooting stars, they are not. In fact, meteors are simply tiny specks of comet debris slamming into our Earth's atmosphere at high speed. You see, every time a comet visits our sun, it sheds tons of debris in its wake. And eventually this debris gets spread out all along the comet's path, its orbit. Then, whenever our Earth plows directly into any path of comet litter, these tiny pieces of this debris slam into our Earth's atmosphere at incredibly high speed. In fact, the Perseid meteors hit our Earth's atmosphere about 50 to 60 miles above our Earth's surface at a speed of 37 miles per second, which is 133,000 miles per hour. Wow! And the resulting friction heats up the gases in the atmosphere, causing them to glow, kind of the way the gas in a neon tube glows. And it is these streaks of light which we call meteors. We do not actually see the pieces of comet debris themselves, only the gaslit paths along which they travel. Now, usually the best meteor shower of the year is every August, when our Earth travels right through a huge stream of comet debris left in the orbit of an ancient comet named Swift Tuttle. And the resulting meteors appear to come from the constellation Perseus, thus the name Perseid Meteor Shower. So this year, on the morning of Tuesday, August 12th, grab yourself a lawn chair, head far away from city lights, and watch the heavens weep once again on the night, or in this case, morning of St. Lawrence's Tears. And the next time you're in Rome, you may want to visit the Church of San Lorenzo, where it is said you can see the very gridiron upon which St. Lawrence supposedly met his grisly end. Keep looking up!
Make the Stars Your Own is available on DVD or VHS for $19.99.